Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe. You can find me Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at Photoshop Cafe. Today I'm going to show you how to relight a scene inside of Photoshop. So we have this daytime scene with this brick wall, and then what I've done is I've just grabbed some lights here. Actually, I just grabbed one, cut it out, and then duplicated it twice. So we have three lights there now that we can use as our light source. And then also I went into Adobe Stock and grabbed a picture and just kind of cut this out. I've got a ton more tutorials that show how to cut it out, but just to give us a foreground interest, you know, element. All right, so let's go ahead and do our lighting right now. We're going to change this from daytime to nighttime. So what we're going to do is we're just going to duplicate this. Just hit Control or Command J to duplicate the layer, and we're going to be working on a copy of that brick wall. All right, so let's go. We're going to choose a filter here. We're going to go under the render menu, and everything in the render menu will only work inside of RGB mode. So if you're in CMYK mode, these will be grayed out. All right, so let's go render, and we're going to choose lighting effects. This is a great filter that I'm really surprised I see so few people using it, and it's so useful. All right, so here we go. We've basically got lights in here that we can choose different types of lights. You know, we got spotlights, floodlights. Maybe I'll do another tutorial where I go into all these settings or something at some other time. But right now I'm going to show you just what you need to know. So one of the things you can do is go into the presets. And we want three lights. So rather than having to create them, we just go into the presets here and we can choose three down. So let's do that right now. And it will start off with three lights. Notice you can select any of those lights for the one that we're going to work on. So let's start with this one here. And I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller. So see that little, we can drag it around by these different points here. See that? And we can also, as we move them up, we can drag these and we can scale them as well. So if we want to make them smaller, whatever, we can do that. So let's make these a little bit smaller. Maybe about, let's just kind of move it around a little bit to about there. That's nice. And if you want to rotate, just drag outside. And that'll give us a kind of a lighting effect. Okay, that's kind of the first one. So let's just position these and size them first. And then we'll get into, or you know, all the other kind of stuff that we're going to do. So let me do that right now. All right, so we've got three lights there. Okay, so let's look at some of the settings here. We can change the intensity of these lights by clicking and dragging there. Notice that this one becomes a little bit brighter. And we can adjust the fall off. Is the stuff in the middle there. We can do that by simply going down under the hotspot, and we can reduce that. See that? And that actually gives that light the fall off there. So let's do that at about 79. Now if you want to change between lights, we just click on each one. We're going to drop that hotspot down a little bit. And maybe make them just a little different on each one, just because that'll give a bit more realism, because these lights are probably not all the same. Some of these bulbs have been around a little bit longer. So let's change the color of the light by clicking on color. And I'm just going to give it just a tiny little touch of yellow. Notice that? Not a lot. And let me do the same here. We're going to give that one a little color there. And finally that one. Yeah, maybe make it, you know, we can make it more orange. There we go. So we didn't do a lot with that color, but just a little bit, just to kind of offset it. But notice everything is pitch black around it, but the lights themselves are looking good. We want to kind of lighten up the background a bit more. We can do that, the ambience. So that would be like an ambient or an existing light. See that? Bring it up to there, and it's looking pretty good. All right, let's click OK, and now we're just going to apply these light effects right now. So there's a couple of things we need to do. One of them is, you notice we've got some in the sky there. The sky is not really going to show the lights. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab our bottom layer, and you would just click the padlock to unlock it. And we're going to apply a LUT to this. So we're going to go under the LUT, and we're going to give it color lookup. And then under color lookup, you'll see the LUT there. Click on there, and we're going to choose moonlight. And see, that gives it a little bit of a night scene now. So we can drop the opacity down just a little so it's not so intense. And we just want to apply it at the top part there, because what we want to do is just kind of have the sky, you know, because this light would not be illuminating through the sky. So what we're going to do is we're going to go there, apply a layer mask on top. And now we're just going to make a selection around there. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill that selection with black, which is going to be Control Delete, Control D. And now you can see, you know, we'd maybe drop it down a little bit so we can get just a little kind of a blending of this effect here. Let's just play around. We'll turn that all the way up. And let's turn that LUT down a little bit. And that's not bad. Okay, so one of the things that's missing, though, is these lights are not lit up. But you can see that the light is now being cast on the wall and not on the sky, which would not be realistic. So what we need to do to add a little realism, though, is light up these lights. So I'm just going to create a new layer. And then I'm just going to grab a white brush. So let's just grab the B for the brush tool. Make sure we've got a very, very soft brush to turn our hardness all the way down. And let me make that a little bigger. I'm just hitting the right bracket key. So we got it about the size there. And let's just make sure that we choose white as our color. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to dab in there. Just click once. I'm going to click once on there. And once on there. And what that's doing is just kind of turning the light on. I might give it a little bit of a glow. So now I'm going to increase that brush a little bit more. And this time I'm going to take the opacity down to about 10%. And I can just hit the one key to set it 10% and just click a couple of times. There we go. And see, we're just kind of giving that little bit of ambient glow there that you might get from the light. So there we go. Just kind of doing that. Maybe a little over here because this is kind of how a real light would work. There we go. And if you wanted, you could add a little color. So just hit Control U if we want. And, you know, if we wanted to give it a yellowish color, we just turn our saturation all the way up. And let me just find the color we're looking for. And there we go. So just kind of play around about there. All right, so we've kind of lit that up now. And at this point here, you know, we can kind of turn on our foreground element and we can kind of have our person here just kind of going there. And, you know, if we wanted to do lighting effects and paint some shadow or whatnot on her, we could also do that. But I'm just kind of doing that just to add a point of interest, not to get accurate lighting on there. Because, you know, she could be lit from a different light source, maybe in front, that we're not necessarily seeing the light, you know, kind of close to where the camera is. And there we go. So that's essentially how you can relight a scene inside of Photoshop. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, don't forget hit that subscribe button. Become part of the Cafe crew. You'll get a new tutorial at least once a week. Also, if you like this, smash that like button into dust. Add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. That would be a discussion going. And until next time, guys, I'll see you at the Cafe.